I can't see the light. Yeah, it's there. Hello, everyone. Good evening. I'm Aradhana Tiwari from Be the Change by Aradhana, and I'm an Access Consciousness Certified Facilitator and the founder of this page of Be the Change. I'm happy to be here. I'm just waiting how many of you are here so that I start. So Nari, you're going to be there?
Yes, I'm here.
So would you put yourself off screen?
Yeah, I've already put myself.
I can see you. Are we there? Are we online? Guys, hope you can see me. I'm still finding to see myself. Yes, we are on. Okay, thank you. So welcome everyone. I'm so happy you guys are here. I really, really can't see because I'm on the Zoom link and I really can't see who all are here with me right now. But thank you, whoever is here. Thank you for being here. And I'm so, so grateful. And today I'm really, really, really excited to have my guests. Before that, I just wanted to let you know whosoever is joining us new. This Be the Change page and this talk show is just an inspiration to many of those who are actually choosing to give up at some point of their life. So my invitation of not never give up, never give in, never quit. And I just wanted to invite you to different possibilities and spaces where people have actually followed their heart and never given up. And, you know, and they knew something different was possible and they didn't want to be like average, normal, like others. And they had their own back. And that's when they created a different reality for themselves. So it's such an pleasure to actually interview all these people and know their life stories and, you know, and what an invitation they are for all of us. So I just like, that was a little bit of a choice of mine, actually creating this platform for all of you who can be inspired by their life stories and actually choose to come out with your gifts on this planet and make this world a different and a better and a greater place to live in. So I won't take your much time now. So I just wanted you to, I will introduce our guest of the today, who is Rohit Jugraj. And Rohit Jugraj Chauhan is an Indian writer and director in the Punjabi cinema and Bollywood film industry. He has written screenplay for films like Players. He was assistant director to Sanjay Leela Bhansali and Ram Gopal Verma. And as Rohit says, he's from a small town, middle class family to being selected to study in medicine in one of the biggest colleges of the country to realizing that his contentment in life laid somewhere else, bringing up the courage to make the switch from the doctor to the film director from one of the most secure professions to highly insecure, competitive profession. And he says, the most importantly, still going on discovering and rediscovering myself. So I'm so excited to today. And to give a brief, he and me have been our childhood buddies from school. And I am so, the moment I came to know that he has chosen this and he shifted his profession, it was a thrill in my life. I'm so excited and honored to today actually welcome my friend here and have a conversations with him and wonder what inspiration can he be to you all. So Rohit, can I have you on screen and welcome here on Be the Change Talk Show.
Hi, guys.
Hello. Thank you, Rohit. Thank you so much. It's such a pleasure to have you here. I am so excited and thrilled.
Yeah. Let me take a screenshot of this first.
So there, the director is already in the move of taking the shots. Thank you, Rohit. Thank you for that. So, Rohit, I am so inspired and I don't know where to start. It's so much to say about you. And I just remember you from my school days, your face, as I remember, Rohit has always been the most intelligent student in our school. And you know, put out all the teachers and he kept everybody happy in space and places. And, you know, and the favorite of everyone in the school, like, say, from any little child to the principal and every teacher.
Yeah, and my mother still says what went wrong from there.
So, yeah, I would like you to start your story and let us know what happened. And I remember you coming from the doctor background, and we always thought that you'll be a doctor. So what shifted, what happened? Can we just know your story from your amazing journey?
Yes, amazing, yes. I think, you know, first of all, Aradhana, I really thank you for having me here. I think all our journeys are very amazing. All our journeys. But I like, more I delve into life, I realize that we kind of either undervalue our own journeys. All of us have, be it, we've crossed emotional hurdles, chote bade jaise bhi, but we have, you know, we've crossed financial, business hurdles, career hurdles. So for me also, I was inspired by a few people like these. I would read about so many filmmakers. I would read about actors. I would read about sportsmen. I remember reading about Tendulkar, how he used to keep practicing on the nets at Shivaji Park. Like, this is when I was in the medical college and I was reading about him. I remember reading about Sushant Singh Rajput, who was a TV actor then, but he was in IIT, like he was preparing for IIT and things like this. So it always is inspiration begets inspiration. You know, you get inspired by reading of lives of other people. That was one major factor that gave me the courage to make the shift from a medical college. Like you said, I mean, like, you know, we are from small towns, and that small town, in a small town of Haryana, who I had not even probably lived in Delhi, coming into a boarding school in Delhi, Army Public School, for my 11th and 12th. And it was a cultural shock. Matlab, skirt ki length choti thi aur school ke campuses bahut bade the.
Yeah. I'm sure you loved it, Rohit.
yeah, really. You know, for a small town guy, it was just really a cultural shock, in the sense that, but I believe those were my two formative years. Living in the boarding school of Army Public School, and then everything, bunks at night. So I used to be this Bibba Munda, okay? I was this, like you said, this nice, decent guy, and my mom still wonders what went wrong. So what went wrong, I think, was I discovered myself. I just didn't want to be good anymore.
Wow. Was it that you were being good, if I may ask? Was it a pressure to be good when you were being good in school? That's what I like remember.
See, one thing, like you keep telling me, I would be the teacher's pet. I would say yes to everybody. Gradually, I realized that I became tired of being everybody's pet. In the sense, see, when you're growing up, what is it for a middle-class boy or a middle-class girl? Everybody wants you to score good. Everybody wants you to do better, good in sports. You know, good, yeah. Do good in debates. Everything else is garnishing. Matlab wo to theek hai, icing on the cake hai, but marks, your marks have to be very good. Everybody's so hell-bent on it. Yeah. So, well, I'm that guy whose marks were good.
Yeah, totally. I can vouch for that.
No, I think I'm that guy who got into...
I was jealous of you. I was like, yeah. Everybody pays so much attention to this guy, man. Like, kya hai? Ye kya baat hai?
Yeah, the girls never paid the attention. That's the only...
No, I think you were very busy taking attention from the teachers, that you didn't even pay attention to the girls who were paying attention.
To the girls. Could be. So, you know, like I was saying, that for a middle-class boy or a middle-class girl, then kya hai? Medicine ya engineering, ab marks achche kar lo, bahut achche se padho, fir medicine pe jao, engineering mein jao, MBA karo. So I was that guy, okay, who got into DPMT, who gets into MAMSI, Maulana Azad Medical College, New Delhi, right? And with a good rank and stuff. Now, this is after Army Public School Hostel. So I had started becoming sort of a rowdy in the Army Public School. Like, I would break rules and I would question. One most important thing that I believe is that we should question. It is not just the prerogative of teenagers. believe me, we as adults also question, should question. We stop questioning. हम वो follow करते हैं, हम condition हो जाते हैं इतना. We just keep following things as we are told to do.
True.
Yeah. With that
question, so rightly said. Question just opens up a different possibility. Like, I'm so glad you did. Like, yeah.
Matlab, first of all, my question was with myself that why, what is it that I want from life? Matlab, in the third year of medicine, I asked myself, that was the third year of medical college. See, if you look at a few facts, the way our country runs, you are either 17 or 18 when you enter a medical college. I was 18. I mean, I didn't know my hands from my ass. Like, come on, 18, right? By the time you're in the third year, you're 20 or 21. Okay, that's where it'll go. For a medical college I'm talking about, that's when I started asking myself that, do I want to spend my life looking at diseases? It's a very noble profession. My father is a doctor. My sister is a doctor. Rachna, you know her. She was in Lady Harding Medical College. So it's a family of doctors. And like I said, you know how it is. Ki acha abhi wo doctor ke bachche ho to doctor hi banoge.
And going to the most prestigious colleges, both of you, like, wow, you know. And it's not like you just left a regular college.
I have learned to question that, who decides what is a prestigious college? You know, who decides that? Is the society that has set up certain norms ki yaar ye rankings hai, ye bachchon ko bhed bakri jaise, jab inke ye marks aayenge to ye is colleges mein jayenge, right? Or then they will have a secure future. Yes, they will have a secure future. Usse pooch to lo, wo khush rahega ya nahi rahega. Either you inculcate him in the wisdom to know at 18 years of age that he wants to become a doctor, he will remain this till he's 75, 80, 85, whatever.
Yeah.
18 साल की एज में या तो उसको इतना विजडम दो, है ना? और या इतना करेज दो, या वो करेज खुद पैदा कर ले कि नहीं बॉस, जब चेंज करना है तो मैं चेंज कर लो.
Yeah.
So in the third year of medicine, like I was telling you, I started questioning that, यार क्या मुझे ये पूरी लाइफ करना है. एंड आई न्यू वेरी वेल दैट, सो आई न्यू वेरी वेल दिस इज द मोस्ट सिक्योर प्रोफेशन. अब मेरे कॉलेज से एक पैटर्न है, मैमसी से, एम्स से, दिल्ली के आपके जितने मेडिकल कॉलेज है, यूसीएमएस से, एलएच से, जो बैच की स्ट्रेंथ होती है ना, जैसे मेरे बैच में 120 से लेके 140 तक स्टूडेंट्स थे, मतलब एट वेरियस क्लासेस, उस बैच में से 60-70% अब्रॉड चले जाते हैं, ओवरसीज. My own sister is a doctor overseas, right?
Right.
Some of my very good friends from the medical college are the best of friends from the medical college that I made, that they are overseas. So right. The point is that aap India mein rehne ke liye bhi nahi pad rahe ho, aap ek apni personal achhi life ke liye, aur usme koi harm nahi obviously, but aap usi liye pad rahe ho. Ek set pattern hai ki aap MAMSI ya kisi bhi medical college se cross karoge, आप यूएसएमएलई या प्लैब दोगे. प्लैब इज द यूके एग्जाम. बेसिकली यू ईदर गिव एग्जाम्स फॉर टू स्टडी हायर स्टडीज एज अ डॉक्टर इन यूएस और इन यूके एंड देन इवेंचुअली गो देयर. आई आस्क्ड मायसेल्फ, इज दिस व्हाट आई वांट? एंड बाय देन यू नो आई हैड स्टार्टेड, आई हैड ऑलवेज बीन राइटिंग स्टोरीज, आई यूज्ड टू डिबेट अ लॉट, आई हैड स्टार्टेड गोइंग टू कॉर्बेट नेशनल पार्क. तो पहले मैं वॉलंटियर करता था वहां पे जाके, वहां पे बीबीसी की टीम शूट कर रही होती थी, डिस्कवरी वाले, नेशनल ज्योग्राफिक वाले, तो मैं उनका इक्विपमेंट, बड़ा हेवी इक्विपमेंट, मैं इक्विपमेंट उठाता था, ठीक है, उनके साथ मचान पे बैठा रहता था. आई स्टिल रिमेम्बर लाइक दैट टर्निंग पॉइंट वॉज दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉलेज से थर्ड ईयर मेडिसिन थोड़ा रिलैक्स होता है, सो वो उससे एक एक महीने के लिए गायब हो जाता था. तो जब मैं वापस आता था ना, तो आई स्टिल रिमेम्बर माय टीचर आस्क्ड मी, it was my pathology teacher, so she asked me, मैं लंबे बाल हो गए थे, jeans फटी हुई थी, so she asked me,
so you were all set for the media world.
I was gradually getting set. So she was like, घोड़ा क्या है, बार बार क्या है? And I entered the medical college. So I'm saying that I had to, that was a time when I realized that, so that was wildlife documentaries. I was introduced to the camera through wildlife documentaries. I think I was lucky like that. Because mm-hmm. those people are meditative. They sit yeah. for days and months, matlab days and weeks, months to nahi, days and weeks on machans. Matlab wo urination ke liye, daily activities ke liye bhi niche nahi aate hai. They just sit there ki ek tiger ki glimpse milegi. Wow. So that intensity, that passion I saw in them, I still remember it was, you know, a fairly old gentleman who was the cameraman. So I thought that I'm fascinated by the camera. Like I want to be a cinematographer, like, mm-hmm. you know, a director of photography. So mm-hmm. I asked him, I was asking him about courses of that. Then he stopped me. He said, do you know you like stories? You like the camera because it is a tool of saying stories. So I said, yaar sala budda baat to sahi keh raha hai. Another thing that I've learned is that please be open and receptive to people who have more experience than you in life and people who you respect in those fields.
Yeah. Wow.
So,
that's amazing.
Yeah. People, you know, who you really respect, if you really respect their work. Yeah. Like this was BBC Channel 4 Katin. They were shooting something for National Geographic and I really respected their work. When he said that actually you want to say stories, then I started introspecting.
So it means you mean you say the stories can be inspiring, right? So like we all live in our stories, Rohit. Like, you know, we've been living our stories, you've been living into your story. And that's what I generally, when I facilitate, I'm like, you know, how many stories are we get, you know, giving ourselves each moment to keep ourselves engrossed rather than creating a story which can be so inspiring and it can lead you to a different possibility. So, and now here you come with the story. So I wonder what stories did you have and what really fascinated you about stories?
Mandabhai, I asked myself, jab usne mujhe ye bola na, when the that cameraman said this, I came back to Delhi. So Corbett National Park is overnight from Delhi. Okay.
Yeah.
I was coming back in the train. Main puri raat soya nahi. I still remember. I was sitting by the door of the train so that, and the wind kept hitting my face. And I kept asking myself, I was 21. And I kept asking myself, here I am studying to be a doctor. Matter of 2 more years and I will be a full-fledged doctor. Is this what I truly, truly want out of life?
Wow.
And then the answer was dark. Answer was dark because, yeah, if not a doctor, to fir tum tab sabse pehle to apne father se, apne parents se kaise bologe? Apne dean ko, baki sabko kya karna kya hai? Ye nahi pata tha na karna kya? Stories kehni hai, but stories kehni hai matlab story kaise kehni hai? And so, like I said, I used to write. I had started directing, you know, some plays for the college. But then how do you? It takes courage to even say to your own self that you were studying to be a doctor and you want to make films.
I mean, it's that brutal honesty to yourself.
Yeah, to yourself, first of all.
Tumko
lagta hai, ek minute, bhai, main zara psychiatrist ke paas jata hu pehle check karwata hu. Aur college mein to hai, mere medical college mein hi hai, char kamre chhod ke.
I'm clinic. Sure you were filled with a lot of them around you, like
totally. So the first, it takes courage to say to yourself, because it sounds bizarre even saying to. I used to get up in the middle of the night. I would really get up and sit, or mere close friends jo the unko maine jab ye bola to everybody looked at me and they said, acha theek hai chalna kal surgery ka exam hai padh tu. So they were, yeah, because who would believe you? And by then, kya karta tha? Aur fir main Corbett na chote-chote trips lene lag gaya tha. And I started making these short films kind of things there.
But may I ask you a question? Were you scared to tell it to your parents? Like, I know it was so brutally honest to be yourself. And how about your parents? And it's like,
I didn't tell it to them till the last moment. Wow. Well, till the last moment. I didn't tell it to them till the time mera path chartered or clear tha mujhe. Tab tak maine unko nahi bataya tha. In the sense, because yaar, main kya bolta? Ki aisa hai, aap to soch rahe the main doctor banunga, lekin main doctor nahi banunga. और मैं मुझे नहीं पता है मैं क्या करूंगा, लेकिन मैं फिल्म्स में कुछ करूंगा। अब कुछ
करूंगा। Was there a pressure when you told them like to complete your medical?
So I'll tell you, I told them much later. I told them when तब कॉलेज में इंटरनेट नहीं होता था, कुछ नहीं होता था, राइट? ऑब्वियसली ये फोन्स पे तो इंटरनेट होता नहीं। एंड सो आई स्टिल रिमेम्बर अप्पू घर है ना, अप्पू घर के पास पीछे कोई एक रेलवे कॉलोनी थी, वहां पे एक फ्रेंड था मेरा जीके, ओके, गौरव सरदार था, बहुत अ वेरी नाइस फेलो, ही वुड ऑलवेज बी वेरी जोवियल। उसके घर पे फ्री इंटरनेट था। मैं रोज रात को पहुंच जाता था, रात को बंक करके हॉस्टल से अगेन दीवार वीवार कूद के, और मैं पहुंच जाता था वहां रात में, पूरी रात रहता था, सुबह अर्ली मॉर्निंग वापस आता था। वो सोचता था, मतलब वो एक दिन आया वो देखने, उसको तो पता था, उसकी मॉम सोचती थी ये पता नहीं कंप्यूटर पे ये दोनों लड़के क्या करते हैं, और पेरेंट्स को होता है ना कुछ गलत चीज नहीं कर रहे हो एंड ऑल दैट। वो मेरे साथ बैठता था, हम सिर्फ यूनिवर्सिटी सर्च करते थे, और वो मुझे कह रहा था कि यार तू आर्ट्स के कोर्सेस सर्च कर रहा है। आई डिडंट इवन नो व्हाट फिल्म स्कूल इज, व्हाट फिल्म स्कूल टू जॉइन, हाउ टू गेट थ्रू। सो आई डिड दिस कंटिन्यूअसली फॉर 40 टू 50 डेज, बट एंड आई मेड मेथोडिकली आई मेड नोट्स ऑन एवरी यूनिवर्सिटी इन द यूएस, इन द यूके, इन यूरोप। मतलब वो मैं अगर थीसिस उस पे निकाल देता ना तो वो ही बेस्ट थीसिस जो हो जाती। मैंने अपनी रैंकिंग करी थी फिल्म स्कूल्स की।
वाओ,
बिकॉज़ इट्स बैचलर ऑफ फाइन आर्ट्स, इट्स बीएफए, दैट्स हाउ इट इज टर्म्ड इन द यूएस, यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स, और इट्स एमबीए। अगर आपको उसके बाद इफ यू हैव टू यूज एमबीबीएस एज ए ग्रेजुएशन, तो मुझे जीआरई देना पड़ता फिर तो। हाँ, वो दो एग्जाम्स जीआरई एंड दैट इंग्लिश का एग्जाम टॉफल एंड ऑल दैट। सो आई स्टडीड दैट, देन आई वेंट, आई found out about all that, then I went to the US embassy, they sent me to a place called United States ka center tha, ek center tha where they said you go there and study and they'll guide you about the GRE thing. To main medicine bhi padha tha, main apne medical college exam ke liye bhi padhta tha, main apne doston ko bola tha mujhe kaise bhi karke pass karwa do yaar, mere ko nahi karna, main doctor nahi banunga, tumko bata raha hu. Ab ye baat pahunchi mere dean tak, theek hai? So wo, because it won't stay there, right? So I remember the dean calling me and he said, does your father know about this? Because by then we were in the final year and I was preparing for USMLE, for GRE. I was very clear that I need to get really good GRE scores so that I can crack a nice film school. Ab mujhe ye samajh mein aaya fir ki bhai mehenga hoga film school bahut. वो वहां पे, बिकॉज दैट्स अ लग्जरी कोर्स, जो स्कॉलरशिप्स हैं वो बहुत लिमिटेड है। फिर टीचिंग असिस्टेंटशिप के लिए अप्लाई किया, बहुत सारे पापड़ बेले, बॉटम लाइन भी, क्योंकि
डिड यू गेट द स्कॉलरशिप और वर यू लाइक,
सो आई गॉट द स्कॉलरशिप, बट इवन डिस्पाइट दैट द कोर्स वाज वेरी एक्सपेंसिव बिकॉज आई कुड नॉट, दे डिड नॉट गिव मी अ फुल स्कॉलरशिप। आई गॉट रियली गुड स्कोर्स इन माई जीआरई, लाइक द परसेंटाइल वॉज रियली गुड, दैट्स वाई आई मैनेज गेटिंग थ्रू टू NYU. Which was, so they had a डेढ़ साल का baccalaureate course था, Peter Stark करके, there was one program which was basically for students like us who will realize later in life. मतलब I didn't want to spend 3 more years.
Right.
अब जैसे I wish, you know, like someday I want to reach a position where I can implement these changes in our own country. Like these have to be policy changes here.
Yeah.
यार अगर किसी ने 3 साल लगा दिए graduation करने में, तुम उसको अब फोर्स मत करो ना कि तूने ये कर लिया है, अब तुझे अगर चेंज करना है तो तेरे को दोबारा 3 साल लगाने पड़ेंगे। अगर साइंस से आर्ट्स में जाना है, आर्ट्स से साइंस में जाना है, कोई भी स्ट्रीम, कोई भी फील्ड चेंज करना है, वो नहीं होना चाहिए। सो देयर दे हैव दीज कोर्सेज विच आर मोर देन अ डिप्लोमा, लेस देन अ डिग्री, इट इज समथिंग कॉल्ड अ बैकलोरियट विच दे यूज टू हैव। तो वो 1.5 साल का कोर्स था। तो जब वो क्लियर हो गया ना, सो आई स्टिल रिमेम्बर दिस कंबाइंड मीटिंग विद द डीन एंड माई फादर। So I didn't know that the dean has called my father. Wow. And I entered and said, mere hisab se to mujhe, this is how my father got to know. Mere hisab se to mujhe unko batana tha abhi. Okay.
Yeah.
And he's already sitting in that room with him. Maine bola bete gaye. Magar Rohit gaya tu. So main andar enter ho, sabse pehle maine darwaza band kiya. Maine kaha ye jo mere ko datenge marenge to yahi rahegi baat. Aur sabse pehle दरवाजा बंद किया एंड
आई विश आई हैड सीन दीस सीन्स रोहित लाइक आई रियली लाइक I'm really visualizing when you're talking. It's like really yeah. Rohit could do that.
yeah, you know, you can imagine that seedha ladka from
you know how we perceive and how we form you know kind of opinion throughout your life and those memories stay with you and then you don't think somebody can actually move out of the box from there. And I so see you right now and I'm like, oh, and you know, it's like aha moments in my world right now going, wow. Wow, what did he do and how did he do? Wow. Some guts, man, some courage. But thank you for that invitation. And I'm sure it's being an invitation for a lot of people here who are listening. Who we like always scared. Family ko kya bolenge, parents ko kya bolenge, logon ko kya bolenge, you know, the world.
Yeah, exactly.
Crazy, yeah.
My only thing will be, yaar, log wo kuch matter nahi karte. Tumne apne aap ko kya bolna hai, wo matter karta hai.
So then when you took that call, were you happy? Like, I mean, did that really make sense to you? Like you fought with your parents, you fought with the whole world and you just took the choice and you followed your heart wherever you wanted
to. The whole world, haan, yaar. Yeah. Matlab, main apni girlfriend se jo ladai, wo to batai nahi hai, usme to aaya nahi.
Yeah, so there was another aspect of Rohit, which I probably would like to bring in, that he did make a girlfriend when he was as usual. We are supposed to be having a girlfriend when we are becoming doctors and then supposed to get married to them. And so did you find one there, Rohit?
No, I found one, but you know, then so I think she was understanding enough, like it took her some time because yeah. See, she had fallen in love with a doctor and we were in the same medical college and then it took her some time, but I'm really glad she was very supportive. And she understood later, and you know, we went our own ways. But those few years were painful because, see, I went to the US. She was studying her medicine here. So all these are scenes that will find way in my story someday in a film that I make someday.
You must. I think this should be a hit movie for yourself.
hopefully, yes, inshallah. And it would probably be, these are better scripts than the ones that I've made already.
Yeah, I get to that.
And, you know, so just there, then in New York, and it wasn't easy. You have to work. So I used to wait on the tables. I used to work at the gas station. I still remember New Year's Eve thi. And I was waiting on the tables or kisine at an Indian restaurant. So there was this South Indian gentleman, I still remember, he was from Andhra Pradesh. So he gave me, uski beti ka birthday tha. Aur main, you know, ek young sa ladka wahan pe bhaag raha hu, kud raha hu, sab kar raha hu. Because I was waiting on the tables so that I could supplement my income and earn for the course as well. So he gave me that $20 ka tip. And wo $20 mein se $10 jo restaurant owner tha usne le liye, because you've gone there to study, you haven't gone there to work. So first of all this that is happening, you it's a matlab wo tumko kaam karne de rahe hain to wo kehte hain ki ehsaan kar rahe hain,
right?
Yeah, so with those $10 I sat at the bus stop and there was tears in my eyes because it was New Year's and I said, yaar, main doctor ban raha tha. And, you know, but then at the end of that film school, when I looked at the short films that I made, it was all just worth it. Wow. It just feels, you feel something inside you clicks, you know, when you feel that, yaar, ye main karna chah raha hu. Mujhe kuch nahi pata tha, tab bhi ki main ban paunga hi nahi. It's just this that you have set out on a journey. And you know that gives you the most satisfaction. It gives you...
Yeah. So people talk a lot about fear, Rohit. And so like looking at your journey and, you know, when you actually left India and, you know, I don't know how much your dad supported you for the finances. But then, you know, at no given point did you ever think that, did you make a wrong decision or you just were so happy in following your heart that it really didn't bother you? Could you see that something around it?
See, if you talk about life is a series of ups and downs, right?
Yeah.
I know it, you know it. We both have, we have faced our shares of ups and downs in our lives. Right now, I'm living in this really comfortable apartment in Bombay and really nice. But the point is that I can't even step out. Correct. Right. Yeah. The point also is that everybody is looking at the fate of the film industry. कब शुरू होगा, अगले 6 महीने होगा या नहीं, अगले 2 महीने, 3 महीने, 4 महीने. तो ये ups and downs तो चलते रहते हैं, right? The there is no guarantee. The only thing that you can guarantee to yourself is that you love every day of your of what you do. There's this. I just thought of this. I have all my books around. So there's this Japanese book. It's called Ikigai.
Okay. Yeah? Wow.
Right? Ikigai. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it says the Japanese secret to a long and happy life. So the people of Japan believe that everyone has an ikigai, a reason to jump out of bed each morning.
OMG. That's so beautiful, Rohit. I'm a reason having this conversation. Yeah.
You know, that what is your ikigai?
Yeah.
Ikigai, a reason to jump out of bed each morning.
And what is that for you? What is that for you now? Like when you become the director, you're doing some amazing movies, and you know, and when your product like shows up in the world, what is that ikigness in the next for the next step? Like what is so that now, for you?
Now, even now, the ikigai for me is to say better stories. See, as of now, I've made my mark only in Punjab. You know, I've made films with Diljit Dosanjh, fine, but I've made that mark only in Punjab. If you talk about Bollywood, it's practically as if I've just arrived. It's, as in, by just arrived, I mean, I yet have to make those films in Bollywood that will inspire people and entertain both. You know, I have to lift my Filmfare Awards. I have to lift my Oscars. That is my guy.
That so is there's a guy called Amrish Ranjan.
I want to make my country proud of me. I want to make my nation proud of me. That's my ikigai.
I'm very proud of you anyway. Like, I'm already so proud. Even the day I came to know that you did this, I was like, that time I didn't even meet you, Rohit. I remember I just heard that, you know, you become a film director and you suddenly left your medical and got like, I don't remember the space in the place where I was standing. My head went like popped out of my head. Like, he did that? Seriously, guys, I was so longing to meet you and see you and, you know, figure it out. What happened? And that is such a proud moment. And it's still, I take a pride in that, you know, I'm your buddy. I'm your schoolmate. He's my schoolmate who did that. I really
respect this, that you are, that when you use the word that it was a proud moment for you. Yes.
Yes.
Because it was much, much later that, you know, people accepted me. And they accepted that they are proud of me. So I'm really happy when I hear this from you, Aradha.
Yeah, no, it was. I didn't know what you were creating, what you were not creating. Just that whole courage of you leaving the medical college to something what you really dreamt of. And you followed your heart. Was such an aha moment for me. And, you know, now listening to your life stories and stuff, it's such an invitation. And that is what I facilitate in the world. And that's what is my work as to, like, you know, question, guys, live your life. You are the change. And when you actually work from the space of total joy, when you really enjoy it, that's when everything follows. Then there is no fear, there is no, you know, greed, there is just the passion that you keep going on. And I wonder what would you like to invite that. And there was somebody I just read, Amrish Ranjan, who said, but being father, he might be sad that time, but you have proved yourself. But at that time, what did your father go or your parents went through?
Yeah.
I mean, had you been caught into that, probably would not been here. And I wonder what your life would have been. So could you say more to people who really don't have that courage to upset their parents and, you know, and families, like what really works here? And even if you would have failed, then what would have happened? Is my question.
Yeah.
Another thing I would add is like, I don't think people who follow their heart can ever fail. I wonder that. What do you have to say about it?
So I was about to say that you know, I was about to say this, that failure ki definition kya hai aur success ki definition kya hai? Wo the definition is happiness, na? Again, ikigai. That feeling that makes you jump out of the bed every morning, that you know that this is that that this is the reason that I want to. So for me, as long as I have that reason throughout the film, throughout my life, see, I will hang my boots on the set. I know this. When I die, I will be on a set making a film. That is enough for me. And that really gives me a lot of satisfaction. Now, to answer your question, yes, it was difficult for my parents. But ek to Indian parents ki na ek bahut khoobsurat baat ye hoti hai, bahut beautiful cheez ye hoti hai yaar, ki wo aapki khushi mein khush hote hain. Ye mujhe nahi lagta hai ki duniya ke aur kisi bhi parents ke bare mein true hai, but ye Indian parents ke bare mein true hai, ye main blindly bol sakta hu, correct?
Yeah.
North India, South India, East India, West India, ye true hai. And वो आपकी खुशी में खुश है. अगर आप उनको ये समझाओगे ना कि नहीं, मैं ट्रूली एक पायलट बन के खुश रहूंगा, मैं ट्रूली आर्टिस्ट हूं, मैं पेंटिंग करके खुश रहूंगा, तो वो आपके स्ट्रगल में, आपके एफर्ट्स में साथ देंगे. फिर आपकी आपके ऊपर है, अभी आपके अंदर कितना करेज और कितना दम है. देखो यार, अगर तुम अपने सपनों, if you don't stand by your own dreams, agar tum apne sapno ki respect ya qadar nahi kar sakte, to koi aur to karega nahi. Wo tumhare sapne hain. They have been given to you for a reason.
Wow.
There is a dream that Aradhna has, there is a dream that Rohit has. Wo interchangeable nahi hai.
Correct.
Tera dream hai Aru. Right? Yeah, mera dream hai. So it's like this, that if I've dreamt of something, it comes with a responsibility also to fulfill it.
Correct.
When you ask yourself, whether it is about having a startup, whether it is about having your own factory, your own business, wo dream tumko diya gaya hai. To wo tumhari responsibility hai, usko pura karna hai ya phir chhod do. Phir maan lo, theek hai yaar, matlab, phir jaise sainkdon karodon log is duniya mein jeete hain, tum bhi jee loge.
Yeah.
Jee to sabhi lenge.
That is so amazing. And now to make it a little more Bollywood and Hollywood style is like, so how about your girlfriends? Like, there's so many single girls who are like, literally, like, is Rohit single? So how about that? What is that twist to your life?
No, I'm very much single. A couple of live-ins, yes. But so I'm very much single. But then also I've realized the personal life has been slightly... I've realized I don't have time for it. The only thing that I have time for is my films, and it gets obsessive. They're long working hours, so I don't blame the ladies. I don't blame the girls, because wo bolte hain yaar tu kaam hi karta rehta hai, and also the insecurities will run high in our field. Correct.
Yeah, totally.
So it has to be somebody who I settle with, has to be somebody who is as passionate and who understands that. If I'm spending 12 hours on the set, that does not mean that I'm having an affair with the actress. It does not mean that at all.
Yeah, that's what I was about to come to. Like, you know, your world, it's like, it's very, very insecure coming from that space. Like, it sounds very insecure, and, you know, people are very, very emotional in film industries. So what is that? Is it because everybody's so involved in the work? But like, when I see you and when I'm listening to you, I don't think you really miss that part of you. Like, it is because maybe everybody's saying it, but you're so passionate about your work and you're so, you know, into your shoots and stuff, that really doesn't make you miss having a partner or not partner, because you're so such self-contented partner to yourself. Can you say a little bit about that? Because everybody looks for that longingness outside them, and, you know, they think other person can complete them.
See, you can't deny that you need a companion, of course, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. You need that person to share yourself with. Sometimes when I come back, the most painful moments are you come back home and you switch on the light. Well, you come back home alone to a dark house and you switch on the light. So, but the point is that what I have learned, I mean, aur ye koi great philosophy nahi hai, main kisi kitab ki baat nahi kar raha hu,
yeah.
I've learned you can't look for happiness outside. You cannot look for your partner or your companion to complete you. That you can't. उस पे अगर dependent रहोगे ना तो फिर यार वो जब वो partner है या वो companion है तब तुम अच्छा feel कर रहे हो. अगर जिस दिन उसका mood off है या वो चली गई या चला गया तो फिर तुम खराब feel कर रहे हो. Your happiness has to lie within. Your completing yourself has to lie within. And then the right partner who walks into your life, and if they respect you, if they like what you, then you guys gel together and you can stay together then.
Wow.
So wow. It largely, you
what
have
gives
to
that
become,
fulfillment, Rohit? What gives that fulfillment? How does you actually acknowledge that you're whole and complete in yourself? What actually made you sense that? Like you said, it's not from the books. It's not your... Is this within from you? So what actually do you
say? I still am not complete in myself. There are days when I'll sit in a corner and I'll sulk, and there are days when I'll cry. There's days when I'll drive my car fast, very fast. There are days when I'll work out nonstop, like, you know, constantly. My trainer goes to pagal ho gaya hai, and because there is so much of aggression inside. So I will be lying if I'll say that I'm complete within myself. No, but I'm finding it, yes. Because at the same time, there are days when it is beautiful and blissful. It's a constant, ongoing journey.
But yin and yang are both a part of it, right? So it's like,
yeah.
Those are also the part of life, and that is also a completeness in yourself. Like, it is not that that's not part of you crying and driving the car fast. So,
yeah.
You know, and... I think that's what I get, that you have to be enjoying that also as like
exactly.
Any other thing, right, in life.
Yeah.
And that's
exactly.
When the whole balance comes in, when we are like, okay to be that and okay to be this. It's like, leaves me so beautiful. Like, I mean, I really sense like you're really, really complete and whole in yourself. And what an invitation you are, Rohit. That's so amazing. I'm like, I mean, it's like, falling in love more and more with my friend, like buddy, who like, oh my god, thank you for the invitation in the world.
I'm so proud of you. I mean, I can't say that enough.
Yes, thank you.
Thanks. There is one thing that I wanted to ask you was, because I've been reading up on your page and otherwise as well, now that we were talking about staying complete within ourselves, so what are the tools, or what is your journey to you know, when, how do you find your completion within yourself?
Yeah, so it's why I think where I can actually, thanks for asking that, Rohit, and that's actually when I can acknowledge that in you guys, because I see that in myself somewhere. And that's when you all are becoming such an invitation for me, because for me also, it's like, I love facilitating. I love life. I love, you know, enjoying every bit of it, whether it's the sadness and the happiness. It's like life moves on. It's a journey which, you know, I have to enjoy the journey part of it also, not the only the end point. So I just look at life every morning, and I have had this tools from Access Consciousness, who's certified facilitator I am. And actually, and I always knew that life can be very easy and simple, and you have to follow your heart. So I follow my heart for everything. I just don't like what you do. And that's why probably it made me very excited when I heard about you, because it was like, yeah, when you follow your heart, everything starts melting around you. All the problems, there's no problems, there's all joy. There is always, and you know, it's a space of you keep questioning, and the life starts keep coming in front of you. And you know, it's easy. And when you actually choose for you, you can never upset anybody. But that's something which has never been taught to us. It's like, it's, you can't be selfish. But I'm like, what if you can have selfish with your own self, and you can look. And you are born as love. You are born out of love, and you are walking, talking love. So, you know, these little things, looking at anybody smiling and anybody joyful, making anybody happy makes me really joyful. Like for me, I really cannot see anybody upset. I just can't, like, can I do something? Can I contribute something? And at the same time, I'm like, okay, it's okay for them to cry too. And that's a choice they're making. So I love facilitating the world. I just like walking, talking magician. I love to, and because I think I see magic in everyone, and that's my whole invitation on this page of Be the Change, that every one of you, as you said, your ikiness of that Japanese book, it so resonates with me, because it's like yes, everybody has a magic in them, has a gift in them.
Yeah.
So I just want to invite and ask everybody to be like you. Like, come on, it's okay. You know, parents will get it. Everybody will get it. They just want you to be happy. And end of the day, if you're happy, you're whole in yourself.
Yeah.
So that's how I look at life. And I'm so, so glad there's so many weird people like me who exist on the planet. And that makes the planet look so beautiful.
Yes,
so thank you for asking. And I wanted to know, like, anything you want to, like, give people, like, some advices, what to follow, like, what would your, like, if you really want to be saying this is Rohit Jugrad's say from the heart advices, what would those be?
Yeah, I'm nobody.
Your journey is endless. I can keep going on, but I'm sure.
Like, exactly. You have it. I'm nobody to give an advice. It's like this, that I'm myself still discovering. So the only mantra will be discover your ikigai. Remember this word. That's the only thing I'll say. So ikigai is the reason that will make you jump out of the bed every morning of your life.
Yeah.
So what is your ikigai? It's a Japanese word. Just try and find that for yourself.
I love the word.
Yeah.
I love the word. I'm going to use it.
By the way, so there is this island in Japan where the average age is above 100,
mm-hmm.
average age, lifespan, and that is considered the happiest place in the world,
mm-hmm.
because they're just very calm and happy people.
Wow. Yeah, they are. So yeah. There's a question from Sonali Singh. She says, he's not Rahul, it's Rohit. You are saying there is no guarantee. What is your reason to jump out of the bed each day? What is your reason to jump out of the bed each day? As I think you said that.
Oh, she's asking, what is my reason to jump out of bed each day?
Yeah.
So my reason is films. Yeah. My reason is, if, like I told you, I still have to win my film fairs. I still have to make my films with the top stars of this country. My production house has to compete with the best in the world. And I still have to get Oscars home. Not once, not twice, but many times. At least three times. I have to get Oscars home for our country. That is my ikigai.
Wow. And then it's like, so anything to balance your life, like what I get that ikigai is, and to have that courage. I know a lot of people know their ikigai, but don't have that courage. So what would you like to say there?
Courage only comes from introspection. Courage comes from a lot of introspection. See, mm-hmm. this is a good question, Aradhana, because I think this is something that I can say has, I have concluded from my experience. Don't let anybody fool you. Wo puri duniya jo bolti rehti na, meditation karo. There is a reason behind it, because it really, the reason that I have figured out it, it helps you calm down and it helps you focus on your own inner self, on an introspect. Usse courage aata hai. Because when you introspect, then you realize that, yaar, this is what I truly, truly want. So when I truly, for example, agar mujhe, bahut simple si baat hai, agar maine decide kiya ki mujhe workout karna hai aaj, ya maine decide kiya ki mujhe 2 ghante ek achhi si kitab padhni hai, achhi si film dekhni hai, ya 2 ghante apne pets ke saath khelna hai, apni family ke saath time bitana hai, kuch bhi. और उसके बीच में वो 2 घंटे के बीच में बहुत सारी चीजें आती है ना, आपको अब YouTube पे टाइम वेस्ट करते हो, सोशल मीडिया पे टाइम वेस्ट कर रहे हो, फ्रेंड्स के कॉल्स आ गए. अगर जब तक आप इंट्रोस्पेक्ट नहीं करोगे तो आपको करेज नहीं आएगा उन सबको नो कहने के लिए, क्योंकि फिर आप अपने बेस्ट फ्रेंड और फ्रेंड्स को बोल सकते हो कि यार मुझे जाना है, क्योंकि वो करेज ऑलवेज स्टेम्स फ्रॉम इंट्रोस्पेक्शन, चाहे छोटा करेज हो या बड़ा करेज हो. एक फौजी जो बॉर्डर पे लड़ता है ना, द गाय हु इज फाइटिंग आउट देयर, उस पे करेज कहां से आता है? उसके पास वो करेज इंट्रोस्पेक्शन से आता है, वेयर ही सेज दिस इज फॉर माय कंट्री. नोबडी लाइक्स टू टेक अ बुलेट ऑन द चेस्ट,
करेक्ट,
बट इट्स ओनली व्हेन यू गो डीप डाउन एंड यू आस्क योरसेल्फ दैट गिविंग अप माय लाइफ विल इट बी वर्थ इट. एंड बिकॉज जो लैंड पे फ्यूड्स होते हैं नेबर्स के, खेतों में, गांव में, विलेजेस में, उसमें भी जाने जाती है ना, उसमें भी लाइव्स जाती हैं. Yes. लेकिन वो जो फौजी है बॉर्डर पे, उस जब वो इंट्रोस्पेक्ट करता है ना, उसको आंसर आता है दैट दिस इज फॉर द सेफ्टी ऑफ माय कंट्री, That is where he gets the courage from.
Right.
If you will introspect, the more you introspect, go deeper. What is it that you truly want out of life? That will give you the courage to make it happen.
So you mean the introspection through the question, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So what introspection you desire and being brutally honest to yourself.
And be brutally honest. Yes, that goes and that goes without saying. I'm expecting. Agar dekho, agar aap apne aap se brutally honest nahi ho, to fir aap abhi fir to KG mein chale jao wapas, yaar. Fir to fir se shuru karo.
Correct.
That is, you know, fir really, that is step one. You will truly, truly have to be honest with yourself.
Yeah.
And this is my mantra. This is what I always do.
Yeah. And so there's a question for you. They're asking that. So is it possible that you might change your career path again altogether?
Okay.
That's a free question.
So this is a nice question. Who's asked this?
Shivangi.
Okay. So
we lost you on the video. Yeah.
There you go. Sorry. Yeah. So this is a nice question, but till now I have not thought of this.
Mm-hmm.
Up till now, I have it has not consciously come to me. But as you say never. Maybe after I have lived my journey as a filmmaker, there'll be something else. But till now, I haven't. Yeah, awesome. This gives me peace and happiness. So I'm good.
Awesome. And then another question from Amrish Rajan is: please say about your mom and her vision towards your vision.
See, my mom is, like I said, my mothers are always happy if their children are happy, right? Their sons, their daughters are happy. So right now also, whenever I'm down, whenever if I'm struggling again in Bollywood, then she gets sad ki, are mujhe to lag raha tu khush hai. But when she understands that, no, it's the journey that makes me happy.
Yeah.
So then she's very happy. She's very happy.
Wow, yeah. That's so beautiful. And I totally get that. I think when you're happy, we think that, you know, if we have chosen our path, what we really love and what we really love to do, there would be like a straight line. It never is. Like a wave also has ups and downs to it.
Yeah.
So I think, but those, then that wave downwards and the descending line doesn't really mind. It looks pretty. It looks beautiful because it's just like flowing with you.
Yeah.
It doesn't really sound really, really falling. It's just like part of the journey, right? That's how I look at the ocean, and then I see it's like, okay, this wave can be in any format, but it depends if you're following the joy and the and that's why I always say follow the joy, and when you follow the joy, everything follows you.
Exactly.
And joy follows joy. But yeah, that's such an invitation. So he says regards to her from my side, and I guess he's some of your friend Amrish. So what else is possible?
Yeah.
So what else would you like to say?
I would like to ask you about. I was reading about this thing called access bars.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
All right. You're gonna interview me. I love that. Thank you. Yeah. So access bars. It's a space which probably I always ask Rohit that I knew that if I'm part of this reality, if I'm part of the whole universal energy. Life cannot be like, I have to just be meditative. I have to, you know, follow certain religions and to be in oneness for everything. I always remember teachers talking about the oneness in our school, in the model science study school.
Yeah.
And that, and the word consciousness from the class third stayed with me somehow. So I was looking for that consciousness word. And this modality, it's like access consciousness. It's not a modality. It's a way of living very differently. So I was like searching for something very easy and instant, like instant coffee. So though my life is always fun, joyful, and I'm like, am I here just to party or do I have any purpose? And for me, purpose was always fun. San Francisco is like, you always have to party and, you know, just want to have fun. I said, yeah, that's what I want. But I thought maybe I'm wrong. So I wanted to know. So then I came across this access bars, which is like 32 points in your head, which you actually, when you touch, it kind of starts giving you that meditative space. It gives you that space which you have been looking for without you doing anything, no eyes shut, no mantra japs, no nothing. And it just gives you that ease and peace, which I was looking, because I had meditated for four hours. And the moment you get up and you're again the same, and I wanted something which was like a walking, talking meditation. So these access bars actually lead you to that space. And the whole mantra of this whole Access Consciousness is to empower you to know that you know. And I was very pleased that somebody is asking from me that what do I know? Like, it's like, you know, the right answer, right question. This is how you're supposed to do. This is how you're supposed to be a good girl. This is how you're supposed to be a good daughter. You know, everything I tried to do, everything right through it, it always went against. And I was like, but where did I go wrong? And I never knew, like, because, and I was like, would anybody ever hear me out? What do I know? And that's when I think I've created this whole space of asking people, what do you know? Because we know something very special. And this is the first space where I was asked this question, what do I know? And from this, Access Bars led to me to different classes and workshops with them. And I'm a certified facilitator worldwide now with Access. And it really helps me. It's really so joyful because this is what really I inspire. And I call and ask people to be in question. And you don't have to know the right answer. And I was so always scared of knowing the right answers. And I used to get bad marks and, you know, then scoldings at home, looking at you, all the students who like flourishing and doing 90 marks, 100 marks, teachers making happy. And I'm looking at you guys and getting jealous. And I'm like, I don't know the right answer. But, you know, I always went in my wrongness. But this was a space which first time asking what's right about you that you are not getting. So these are little tools. And now I give an spread to the world that, hey, what do you know? And what's right about you that you're not acknowledging? So that's when I started knowing that it wasn't that I was slow. I was too fast. I had to return back to get to everybody's language. So I am more energetic language rather than, you know, words and dictionary. And I remember my sister, I always thought that, wow, she's so intelligent. She talks so good English. She has such a good vocabulary. I can't speak that English. I talk very basic English. And that's what I can have. We studied in the same school. I wonder what happened. But, you know, I can read energy language. So this Access Bars leads to you to more of you and gets in touch of you of more. And it has no form and structure. It just makes you acknowledge you. So that's how I got into it. And now I'm like 6 years down, 7 years. I'm in the certified facilitator, facilitating the world and empowering the world to know that you know. Come on, bring up that change, that icky guy in you, and be the change.
Exactly. Be the change.
Be the change. Yes. You being you, you can try and change the entire world. And that was another thing I always thought, you know, we can, how will this whole world change? There's so much going on. And then I'm like, would me just choosing that will change it? But then I got an answer, yes. If one person, we start from ourselves, being happy, joyful in true sense, Earth doesn't require you to actually plant trees and do something, because if you're conscious, you would anyways will not choose that, and you'll choose different. True. So that's my journey. But thanks for asking. And it was a pleasure, Rohit. And I hope if it's a contribution to everybody on this platform. And we all can share this, guys. And I'll be amazing that you guys can share this as much as you can, so that it can really, really inspire everybody on the planet to be that icky and to find their icky guy and, you know, get up for that and be the change on the planet. Yeah. And thank you so much, Rohit. It was such a beautiful, I never want to end up this conversation. It can go on, but I definitely would like to have you again once you have your Filmfare Awards. And then we will, yes, I'm looking forward to that and all the contributions.
So much.
Yeah. Thank you so much, thank Rohit. You. Thank you, everyone pleasure. Who was here, and pleasure. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you. Bye, everybody.